Back in Power BI, we continue along in our introduction to Power BI and DAX. Today, we're going to take a look at the time intelligence functions. We're going to look at first date, last date, end of month, same period last year, and other time intelligence functions that are some of the most common functions. And when you're using a date table, if you can use these functions, it can save you time and really get you some robust sales and documented time intelligence functions. So we're going to take a look at these and show you how you can use them once you create the measure multiple times. It's our introduction to Power BI 2024 series. We recently did videos on date and time functions, and we also have a video out there on some other DAX functions. Let's go and take a look at time intelligence functions in Power BI. Back in Power BI, we continue along with our introduction to Power BI series. Today, we are going to take a look at time intelligence functions. And these are DAX expressions that allow you to work with your data using different time periods. You can use days, months, quarters, years. You can find things like the first date in a sales table, the last date. You can combine these with date functions. We recently did an intro to date functions, and you can build out a dashboard so that the user can quickly see sales, maybe orders, web analytics, and other business analytics in a quarterly, monthly, or year over year in some of those different time frames. So we're going to slowly work with first date, last date, previous day, total month to date, total quarter to date, and we're going to build out some of these in tables and show some examples how you can use these in your data analysis. There is going to be a file to follow along. It's going to be called Pizza Time Intelligence, and you can look for it in the description. Follow along or just watch and see how you can work with your data and use it for time intelligence. Let's start off with our very first time intelligence function, which is going to be the first date. Back in Power BI, we continue along with our introduction to time intelligence. If you click on the description below, you can download the Power BI file. It is called Pizza Aggregations Time Intelligence. You will see a blank file, but it does have a model already set up. It is pizza sales for a pizza place for 1 year. And you'll see the different relationships set up. We do have some tables in this model, including a date table, which you need for time intelligence. We've got an orders table, a pizza type, and also some more information on order details. We are going to be mainly using the orders table and the date table for this video. At the bottom, you can create a new page, and we're going to rename this page Time Intelligence. So that way we can follow along and you can practice with this data model as we show you some of the functions with Time Intelligence. The very first one is going to be the first date. And this is an important function because it allows you to refresh this date if your data changes. And for the user, they can see the date of the first sale, the date of the first order. And it is a very simple DAX function. We're going to go to the top. We're going to be in the orders table. We're going to select new measure. And we're going to name this measure date of first sale. If we hit shift enter, the formula is just first date. And if you use your IntelliSense, first date returns the first non-blank date. And this date table is set up for pizza sales in 2015. So the first date is going to be, it's asking for the date from your date table. And in this table, we have one date table, which is sometimes referred to as a calendar table. We're going to use the date And that is going to bring up the end of the requirements for this. We're going to close it out, hit enter. And now on the right-hand side, your measure is called date of first sale. We want to format this to a short date. Under the measure tools, we will select short date. Every time we use this measure, it will format it to that short date. If we bring in the first date into a visual, the first date of first sale in the orders table is January 1 of 2015. That is a look at the first date time intelligence function. The second function we're going to use is the last date. The last date works very similar to the first date. We are going to go back to the orders table, select new measure. With a new measure selected, we're going to name this date of last sale. And the date of the last sale is going to be asking for the last date. Again, it returns the last non-blank date inside the date table. And the date table is sometimes referred to as a calendar table. And that is the driving engine of your time intelligence. So for the last date, we're going to select tab, and we are going to bring up the date in the date table. We'll close that out with the right parentheses and then hit enter. Now we have our date of last sale. If we bring that back to the home table, we select an open area in the report view, select a card. You can select data to bring into this card. And we're going to select the date of last sale as our visual. We'll make this a little bit bigger, and that will bring the visual. If we bring in the date of the last sale, now that shows you how it brings up the default date. But we want to go back to that date of last sale. Under our measure tools, we want to select short date. And now that will bring up the short date. So we have the date of last sale. How a user, when you're setting up a dashboard, now they can see the date of first sale. They can see the date of the last sale. And we're going to show you how you can use these later on to apply them. If you're refreshing your data and you bring in new dates, new sales dates, these would change when you hit refresh. The next time intelligence function we're going to look at is the previous day total. When you are writing your DAX measures, the current context of your measure is the result that you will see when you pull in the measures to your tables and visualizations. We are going to show you how this works with previous day. We're going to create a table. With this table, we are going to add some data, and we are going to bring in the date, the day by date for this calendar. So it starts on January 1, 2015. And in the file, when you download it in the description below, you will see a total sales measure. When you bring in total sales, you now have the total sales for each day. And this can be handy when you want to look at things like total sales, total orders, total website visits. But the time intelligence function for previous day allows us to see those daily sales at a little bit more of a granular level. And we'll show you how to do that. Basically, what this is asking for is one function. And this is also going to require, in addition to the previous day function, is going to need the calculate function. PreviousDay uses the calculate function to modify the current filter context. We currently have January 1, January 2, January 3rd, and the total sales measure is the result of each of those filters in the table. For the previous day, we want to be in the orders table and create a new measure. And this new measure for previous day is going to ask for two functions. We're going to use the calculate function, and we're also going to use the previous day function. So for previous day sales, the first function is calculate, which we use to modify, evaluates an expression in a context modified by the filters, and the filters in this table are the daily dates. So if we use the calculate, the expression we want to modify is still total sales. So total sales is another measure. Then we are looking for the filter, and the filter is previous day, and then it asks for the dates. And the dates are never going to change once you have your calendar table or your date table. It's going to be the date from the dates table. Then we close it out. We close out the previous day, and then we close out the calculate function. When we bring in the previous day sales, we now are going to have the previous day sales lined up next to the total sales. For January 1, we have $2,713. On January 2nd, the previous day sales are the previous day, which is January 1. On January 3rd, we see the amount is $2,731. What's nice about this, if we remove from the table, we can remove from the table the previous day sales, and that would still leave, if we remove the total sales, it still leaves our previous day sales. And if we add that back in, we can still bring in our total sales and get that in the context of our filter. So for January 1, 2713, and the filter brings in the previous day. As we add in more of these time intelligence functions, you'll see how this works as we build out our table and how we can use those in some visualizations. The next function for time intelligence, we're going to take a look at total month to date. Total month to date for the DAX function for time intelligence. This is going to require the function total month to date, then it asks for an expression, and then it asks for the date table. Inside your orders table, you will select new measure. We are going to call this month to date sales. With month to date sales, you're going to start off with just by typing in your total, you'll see your total options, which are total month to date, quarter to date, and year to date. Total month to date is going to ask for the expression, which is going to be total sales. Then we are going to ask for the date table, which is going to be the date table, sometimes referred to as a calendar table in this file that you download below to follow along. It's going to be, and then you're just going to close it out by closing out the total month to date function. Now, month-to-date sales, again, is context of the current table. So the month-to-date sales, when you bring this in, on January 1, you have $2,713. That is your month-to-date sales. Then on January 2nd, you have $2,731. Your month-to-date sales are $5,445. Depending on the context, which is the date, all the way up until the end of the month, we have $69,793 in sales. And then on February 1, we start off with the new month to date, with February 1 being the context. So that is your total month to date sales. The next one is going to be the total quarter to date. So we're going to use the same format. It's going to be Q to date sales, and it's going to be similar. You're going to use the total, and you're this time you're going to use the quarter to date, which evaluates the specified expression over the quarter. And the quarters are divided up into four quarters of a year, and the quarter to date is going to be total sales for the expression. Then we're going to bring in the date table, and that is going to close out the total quarter to date. And it works very similar. You bring in the quarter to date sales, and the quarter to date sales starts off the same as the month to date, but it goes beyond February 1st. We see that number still rises. It goes up to March 1st. That number rises to the quarter to date. And then all the way on April 1st, it starts new, $2,176. And that is the new Q2. But if you go to your table and you bring out the month to date sales and the total sales, we now can see our quarter to date sales independent of those other measures. So we can use that and just use it by itself. The final measure we're going to bring in is the year-to-date sales. And year-to-date sales could be year-to-date orders, year-to-date website visits, year-to-date conversions if you're using other dates. But we're going to continue on with sales, and we're going to bring in the total, and it's going to be year to date, and the expression is still going to be total sales. Then we bring in the dates, which is the date table. We close out the total year to date, and now we have the measure inside our orders table, which is year to date sales. We bring that back into the table, and if we want to, we can still bring in our total sales. And we could bring in other measures as well. So now we have our year-to-date, our month-to-date, and our quarter-to-date, and they are all working under the context of this table. But if we want to use the no context, we could bring in a card, and that card we could bring in the year-to-date sales, and since it doesn't have any context, it has $817,000, which is the same total for the total sales year-to-date. But this way, you could use that as an independent measure. If you were doing a yearly dashboard, you could bring up your year-to-date sales inside a card and have that be the context. So that is a look at month to date, quarter to date, and year to date for the functions in time intelligence. Next, we're going to show you how to sort by a month number and bring in previous month orders rather than sales. So we're going to work with continuing on. We worked already with previous day. Now we're going to show you the context, use it in a different expression that you're going to evaluate. We'll take a look at previous month. So far with our time intelligence functions in our introduction series, we've already used the previous day measure. Now we want to use the previous month and the previous quarter. And when you're new to time intelligence, we're going to create a new page and we're going to show you some of those different options, because the expression does not need to be total sales. That can be any of our other measures. We have a total orders table, and then we could choose to make a new table. And inside this new table, we can populate this visual with the month name. And when you bring in the month name, the names come in alphabetically. The month names are in alphabetical order. We want to bring those into a chronological order. The way to do that, if you select the month name and we sort by month number, the numbers on the month are 1 through 12, that will bring it into chronological order. Now we have January through December, and we can then take a look at total orders. In January, we had 1,845 orders, because that is the context of the filter when we bring in the month name into this table. To create the new measure, we are going to stay in the orders table. We're going to continue with the expression of the orders, but now we're going to create a new measure, and it's very similar to the previous day. We're going to call this previous month's orders, and what we're going to do is bring in the calculate function, which modifies that current context, which is the current month. The expression is going to be total orders. The filter is going to be previous month, and that is going to ask for the date, which the date is still the date table inside. And then we're going to close out the previous month, and we're going to close out the calculate function. So your previous month orders in the context of this table, as we bring this in, if you notice in January, we had 1,845 orders. In February, we had 1,685. So the previous month's orders is 1,845, and that is in February from January. And it's very similar for the previous quarter. So now we have the different quarters lined up. We can stay in the orders table. We can create a new measure. And the new measure is going to be from the previous quarter. And that is going to be calculated as the expression, which is the total orders. Then we're going to bring in the filter, which is the previous quarter. And the dates are going to be the date table. We're going to close out the previous quarter. We close out the calculate function. And now we can bring in the previous quarter into the table. And now we have the previous quarter sales. There's none in the first 3 months. Then we have 5,370 from January through March. And then that goes all the way up to July. July brings in the previous quarter, and then for the fourth quarter, we have the previous quarter. So you will use these a lot of times when you're trying to compare. If you have some sales dashboards, if you want to bring in a comparison of month over month, your previous quarter, your previous year, or your previous day. But what I tried to show you here is you can use different expressions. In the first one, we use the total sales, and now we're using the total orders. And then we also showed you how to sort those month names by the month number. So that is an introduction to time intelligence function in 2024. We do have additional videos on our introduction video series, including an intro to date and time functions. And we also have a continuing series on DAX for 2024. Remember, you can download the file in the description below and follow along. It is called the Pizza Aggregations Time Intelligence Functions as we continue to learn Power BI.